this is my new 2023 Tesla Model 3. It is the rear-wheel drive version, and now we are going to look at the changes for the 2023 year model. This video is not a review of the Model 3. Rather, I will focus on what changed in the 2023 model and highlight some of the 2022 changes that were carried over. I have been told by the service center that the cutoff date for the 2023 model was October 4th. Mine left the factory on October the 6th. Probably the biggest change, as you might know by now, is the removal of the ultrasound sensors for the car. My 2023 model does not have any ultrasound sensors on the front or back bumpers. You can easily tell by the absence of the little circles that you find. It's now have more uniform look. But with this change comes a setback. There are no alerts or visual indications on the screen when you get close to objects. Tesla says this will be coming in a future software upgrade, but for now, I will have to do it the old-fashioned way. Another change that is rumored to have happened is the replacement of the 1.5 megapixel cameras with 5 megapixel cameras. To be honest, I cannot tell if the cameras look any different. They kinda look the same to me. If you have a Model 3, tell me if you spot a difference. So here are some close-up shots for your reference. Over the past year, many changes have occurred and some were reverted back due to the chip shortage, so I'll go through them one by one to see if my car has them. The upgraded matrix LED headlights are still here. You can easily tell from the glass ball on the sides. The car has the new AMD processors as well as a heat pump. Those stay the same. The front double glass is also still here. I checked the low voltage battery and I can see that I got the lithium-ion battery. Those tend to last much longer than the traditional lead acid ones. The heated option for the wipers, check. And the rear wheel version is still missing some of the interior lights. However, the LEDs themselves are there. They are just disabled in the software, which is a shame. Maybe Tesla will make those available in future add-ons. We'll see. The chargers are still not included with the car, but I bought both the mobile and wall chargers and I will be installing it shortly in the garage. Last but not least, the build quality. I would say nothing major had changed. The build quality is still okay, but I still see some misalignments, defects, and chips. I highlighted mine at the delivery and I was asked to schedule a service appointment the next day. When I brought it in, they said my misalignments issues were within specs. What do you think? Are my expectations too high or is Tesla quality just the Tesla quality? And that wraps it up. I'm happy to finally take delivery of this beautiful car. It's a blast to drive and my nerdy side can start exploring its API and CAN bus interfaces, but that's for another time. Well, I hope I managed to cover all the changes in the 2023 model, but if I missed something, please let me know. Thank you for watching.